using an improvised pulley system to transport supplies over the river at Charco Abajo, PR 3 weeks after Hurricane Maria. Damaged infrastructure is hampering the delivery of aid to remote communities in Puerto Rico. Dennis M. Rivera Pichardo for the New York Times. Want to get this briefing by email? Here's the sign up. Good morning. Before we begin, if you've ever wondered how this briefing gets put together every day, your writer has the answer. Here's what you need to know how to make conservatives happy. President Trump and Senator Mitch McConnell are trying a new approach, judges. In a surprise display of togetherness on Monday, the two men emphasized a mutual desire to fill scores of federal court vacancies. Our chief Washington correspondent, Carl Hulse, explains the courts are a longtime priority of conservative activists who have been grumbling about the failures of the Republican Congress, so a flurry of confirmations of nominees with known conservative views on cultural and government issues could quiet some complaints. After months of tensions, Mr. Trump and Mr. McConnell held a joint news conference in the Rose Garden. Here are some of the topics the president addressed. President Trump and Senator Mitch McConnell at the White House on Monday. Tom Brenner, The New York Times. While answering questions, Mr. Trump falsely asserted that his predecessors, particularly Barack Obama, hadn't contacted the families of American troops killed in duty. Milestone reached against ISIS, the Syrian Democratic Forces, an American-backed militia group made up of Syrian Kurds and Arabs, said today that it had liberated the northern Syrian city of Raqqa from the Islamic State. It's a major blow to the militant groups, which had long used the city as the de facto capital of its self-declared caliphate. The greatest fireworks show in the universe, astronomers are excited. It was announced on Monday that they had observed a pair of dead stars colliding, the first glimpse of the violent process by which most of the gold and silver in the universe was created. I can't think of a similar situation in the field of science in my lifetime, where a single event provides so many staggering insights about our universe, an astrophysicist at the University of Chicago said. We have a video to explain it all, and answer some questions about the discovery. After disasters, dangers remain. One of our reporters, Caitlin Dickerson, visited a remote village in Puerto Rico devastated by Hurricane Maria. Residents, she said, were quick to point out that other Puerto Ricans were living in worse circumstances, though it was hard to imagine whom they could have been talking about. And in California, the wildfires are far from over, but officials are confronting the next challenge, the huge amount of debris and ash that will be left behind. Just think of all the hazardous materials in your house, the chief public health officer in Napa County said. Your chemicals, your pesticides, propane, gasoline, plastic and paint, it all burns down into the ash, Metu. In the past 2 weeks, more than 30 women have accused the Hollywood producer Harvey Weinstein of sexual misconduct. There has been an outpouring on social media of stories of sexual harassment, punctuated by the hashtag Metu. Nina Jacobson, a film producer, predicted a change in the entertainment industry. I think the floodgates being opened is something that had to happen, and that finally brings a subject to the surface that has sort of gone unchecked for countless years, The Daily, your audio news report. In today's show, we discuss the guilty plea by Sergeant Bowie Bergdahl. Listen on a computer, an iOS device or an Android device. Business. The healthcare industry is the job engine of many parts of the U.S., aided by funding as a result of the Affordable Care Act. We visited a county in Arkansas where healthcare accounts for one in four jobs. Some airlines have begun offering free meals and coach on selected U.S. flights. U.S. stocks were up on Monday. Here's a snapshot of global markets. Smarter living tips, both new and old, for a more fulfilling life. Pristine environments for children can contribute to allergies and asthma. Tough workout. Try these five things to speed up recovery. Recipe of the day. This pumpkin bundt cake with a maple brown butter glaze is full of fall spices. A classic showstopper. Jim Wilson, New York Times. Noteworthy biking in New York City. In today's 360 video, ride through the busy streets of a city that has spent millions to improve safety for cyclists. Partisan riding you should anti-miss. Writers from across the political spectrum discuss the state of the Republican Party. They're cute now, but then they grow up. No matter how you raise a wolf, you can't turn it into a dog. Scientists are trying to determine why. Wolf pups at play. Researchers are looking at DNA for the answer to the differences between wolves and dogs. Renaud Philippe for the New York Times. Basketball is back. The NBA tips off its 72nd season tonight. We have previews of the Eastern and Western conferences. Our new basketball columnist, Mark Stein, has covered the league for more than 20 years and says he's never seen a more overwhelming favorite to win the championship than the Golden State Warriors. Best of late night TV, kicking off a week of shows from Brooklyn, Jimmy Kimmel took a jab at its reputation for liberal pretension. All of the jokes you will hear tonight were written in small batches, by hand, on biodegradable hemp parchment, using natural ink that was made from sustainably harvested lingonberries, and we spoke to Mr. Kimmel about his new visibility after he addressed the news in personal terms. Quotation of the day: they may have made a miscalculation of historic proportions by proceeding with the referendum over the objections of just about everyone who counts. Yost Hilterman, an analyst with the International Crisis Group, on the fallout from the Kurdish independence vote. On Monday, the Iraqi government carried out a military assault to wrest territory from separatists. Backstory: Man Booker Prize, which honors the best novel written in English and published in Britain, will be announced today. On this year's shortlist for 3-2-1, by Paul Auster, History of Wolves, by Emily Fridland, Exit West, by Mohsen Hamid, Autumn, by Ali Smith, Lincoln in the Bardo, by George Saunders, and Elmet, by Fiona Musley. One of these authors will win the Man Booker Prize today. Clockwise, from top left: Paul Auster, Emily Fridland, Mohsen Hamid, Ali Smith, George Saunders, and Fiona Musley. Clockwise, from top left: Lot Hansen, Weidenfeld, Nick Olson, Hamish Hamilton, Sarah Wood, Bloomsbury Publishing, and JM Originals. First awarded in 1969, the Booker McConnell Prize was named for the multinational company that established it, as an effort to rival the Prix Goncourt in France. In 2002, sponsorship passed to the Mann Group, an investment management firm, which added its name to the title. The award was initially open only to writers from Britain, Ireland, Zimbabwe, and the Commonwealth. Eligibility expanded in 2014 to include any English-language novelist, raising concerns that it would become dominated by Americans. Since then, one U.S. novel, Paul Beatty's The Sellout, has won. Half of the authors on this year's shortlist are Americans. Winners receive £50,000, or about $66,000. Howard Jacobson, who won in 2010 for The Finkler Question, told The Guardian that he was going to spend the prize money on his wife. Have you seen the price of handbags? Sorry, already contributed reporting. __. Your morning briefing is published weekdays at 6 a.m. Eastern and updated all morning. Browse past briefings here. If photographs appear out of order, please download the updated New York Times app from iTunes or Google Play. What would you like to see here? Contact us at briefing@nytimes.com. You can get the briefing delivered to your inbox Sunday through Friday. We have 4 global editions, timed for the Americas, Europe, Asia, and Australia. Check out our full range of free newsletters here.